Today, I'm going to show you how to softmod a fat PS2. This is going to be a little bit simpler. First, you're going to need a fat PlayStation 2 that has a hard drive bay that takes the Ethernet adapter that's separate. Then, you're going to need a IDE hard drive. That is an IDE hard drive. 40 gigs or more. This is a 200. Then, you're going to need a computer that has IDE connections with the power connection also as well. Gotta make sure that has Windows XP, XP Home, XP Pro, preferably. First, you're gonna look at the connection for your hard drive. You have the jumper settings right here. It has to be under slave. This is incorrect on mine. I don't need a jumper for mine, so I'm gonna remove that jumper right there. The jumper can be removed either by your fingers or a pair of tweezers. It's that easy on this type of hard drive. Maxtor Diamond Plus is the best kind of hard drives I ever use for doing these soft mods. So they're like $20 on eBay. You just type in 200 GB Maxtor IDE hard drive and it'll come up. Then you're going to hook up your hard drive into the second IDE that's available with a power connection to it as well. Then you're going to turn on your computer. After your computer boots up, you're going to boot up your computer, and what you're going to do is you're going to go down and download these files on another computer and put them on a flash drive and hook that flash drive up to this computer, and you're going to extract them. It's going to be SOCOM 2 HDD files, which I have already on here. It's not hard to transfer from computer to computer using a flash drive. Then what you're going to do is you're going to open up WinHip and WinHip.exe. You're going to hit OK. You're going to select the drive. It's going to be a second drive. You're going to hit Format and you're going to select 48-bit. You're going to leave all that the same. You're going to hit OK. And it says you really want to do it, and you're going to hit Yes and OK. Once it's done, you're going to hit OK. You're going to hit OK again. And you're going to close this WinHip out and go back. And you're going to go to the VASH 32 underscore 48 bit PS2 HDD dump. And double click that. You're going to go to HDD raw copy portable. Then you're going to select your image. You're going to double click down there. You're going to pick out in your SOCOM HDD files. Go to VASH. And you're going to go to 48-bit HDD OSD VASH32Dump.imgc. You're going to hit Open. You're going to hit Continue. Then you're going to click on the hard drive. It says Maxtor. Mine says Maxtor. You're going to double-click that or just click once and you hit Continue. Then you're going to hit Start. And you're going to hit Yes. And it's going to go through this process. Okay, once you're done with that, you're going to close this, and close that, and you're going to shut down your computer completely. Once your computer shut down, you want to put this back in the master setting. Once you do that, you want to put your drive in your PS2. You want to make sure you connect it and it lines up properly. Once you put in the drive bay, you want to make sure the screws are snug tight. Now that everything's hooked up, you want to turn on your PS2. Make sure there's no disk in it so it could boot up properly to the browser. After it boots up, you want to go to browser. Your hard disk drive is loaded up properly. There you go. You have a soft modded PlayStation 2. You can launch your ELF files to your flash drive using the ELF launcher. The ESR, you can burn your own ISOs in the ESR launcher and play them in the ESR. I never use OpenNoder because I heard that's out of date. I don't mess with that. I don't mess with GS mode selector. Then there's a
Pop Simulator. HD Loader I have used. You can go in there and put games on your hard drive so you can play them directly off your hard drive. And there's a free MacBook creator, which I don't use because it's out of date too. Any questions, comments, or concerns, just leave them in the comments below. I don't recommend using Western Digital. You could buy a cheap IDE computer from thrift stores. You can get your hard drives on eBay. I prefer Maxer 200 gigabytes. Thank you and enjoy softlining.